So today I'm going to be talking about workspaces inside Premiere Pro. You know, as video editors, we often find ourselves switching from editing to color to graphics. And I was wondering, is there a way to set up your workspaces where you don't have to necessarily switch from one to another? So that's what we're going to be talking about in today's video. Let's dive in. Now, before we dive in, I just want to point out that, you know, every video editor is different, and your needs as a video editor is going to be different from my needs, and this workspace might not work out for you. But in the end, I hope you find some different tips that you might, you know, take away from this video on how to set up a custom workspace and some ideas that you can play with when you're navigating your different workspaces. So when I was thinking about my custom workspace, what I really wanted to focus on is make sure my timeline is really large at the bottom. So I'm gonna place that in the bottom right corner, and then all my program reference monitors and different things like audio meters, the program monitor, tools panel, my Lumetri scopes, anything that kind of shows what the footage or the timeline's saying is gonna live in the upper right quadrant. And then basically everything else is gonna live vertically on the left side. So this is kind of how I wanted to set up my custom workspace inside Premiere Pro. All right, so let's get started and show you guys how to set up a custom workspace inside Premiere Pro. Okay, so the first step is to go up to your Workspaces button and to click Save as New Workspace. I'm gonna name it something like My New Workspace and then click OK. So one of the first things I did is drag the timeline into the program monitor. And then I'm gonna drag the tools panel into the left side of the program monitor. You'll see that little highlighted section. And then I'm also gonna take my audio meters and then drag that to the right side of the program monitor. So now we have everything in that top right corner. Next, what we're gonna do is actually click and drag the project panel into the top left where our effects controls are. And basically all these panels can go up in that upper left quadrant. Now, once we have everything set up here, what we're gonna do next is actually just expand this a little bit. So I'm gonna just slide that bar to the left to make more of the right side more visible. And I'm just gonna fix up my toolbar and also my audio meters by just clicking and dragging those edges to make them a little bit bigger. All right, so now let's take a look at the project panel. You can see they're located in tabs. But one thing you might not realize is that you can actually change the panel group settings to actually go to stacked, where they're actually stacked on top of each other. And this is pretty cool because you can just toggle by clicking just once in between all the different tabs. So essentially my idea is just have all of my different tabs over on the left side all the time. So now we're just gonna go through and just close out the panels that we don't need. And essentially we're gonna add all the panels that we do want to the left side. So we're just gonna close out markers, history, and all of those tabs that I usually don't use. You may use them. Like I said, you know, this is really up to personal preference. So the first thing I'm gonna add is Lumetri color. Just gonna open it up, click and drag it to the center there, and that'll be added to our tabs. Now next is Lumetri scopes, and Lumetri scopes is a little interesting. What I did, you can leave it to the left, but what I did is actually drag it to the program monitor. That way, if I'm color correcting my video footage, I can toggle between the program monitor and the Lumetri scopes to see the different adjustments, you know, that are being made to the vector scopes. Next is gonna be essential graphics. We're gonna click and drag that from the right side to the left side. And same thing with our text panel. If you don't know, the text panel is where your transcriptions and captions are. So I use that all the time to make captions for my videos. We're just gonna click and drag it to expand the menu a little bit. That way it's a little bit bigger. And next we'll add some sound settings. So essential sound I use sometimes. So I'll click and drag that over. And also the audio track mixer, which I use quite a bit for my different audio tracks. I'll add that in there as well. All right, so now that we have all of our tabs, you can see how easy it is to click just in between the program monitor, effects controls, Lumetri color, go back in between each panel without switching your workspace. So that's the benefit of setting up tabs like this that I've found. Now to finish this off, I'm just gonna make some fine-tune adjustments to the different panels. Just make sure all my spacing's down, and that everything's looking correct in each window. Then to finish it off, you just want to go up to your Workspaces button and then click Save Changes to this workspace. This will just save your settings and you should be good to go. And that is essentially how you can create a custom workspace inside Premiere Pro. If you want to learn more about Premiere Pro, there's several tutorials on my channel. I'll link a video that you might like right up there. But otherwise, thank you so much for watching and we'll see you next time.